In this part, we would take up female reproductive system, right? In previous part, we had discussed about male reproductive system. We discussed about the primary sex organ, the accessory ducts and accessory glands, and the external genitalia. Here also, we will follow the same concept. First, we are talking about the primary sex organ, which are ovaries here, right? Then accessory ducts, accessory glands. Here actually we will talk about mammary glands and the external genitalia, right? So we will study the female reproductive system under these headings. So the female reproductive system looks somewhat like this. Is tarike se female reproductive system dikhta hai. Okay, now let us discuss one by one about their labelings. You see the ovaries here, okay? These are called right and left ovaries. So ovaries are primary sex organ. Why they are called primary sex organ? Because they are responsible for the gametogenesis, right? Here we will talk about oogenesis. That means the formation of egg or ovum. Okay, so ovaries will form the egg. Now, next to the ovaries, we will talk about the accessory ducts. Here, these ducts are not very fine. There are some ducts which are fine and some are broad. So, right from the fallopian tube to the uterus, the cervix and vagina, all are ductile part. In sabhi ko duct hi kehte hain. Right? So, accessory ducts ke andar aa gaya aapka fallopian tube. Fallopian tube. And then uterus, cervix and vagina. Okay, ab dekho. First we are talking about here this fallopian tube. Ye fallopian tube hai. This fallopian tube is also known as oviduct. Okay, iska naam oviduct isliye hai kyunki ovaries jo egg ko produce kar rahi hai, these eggs are carried to the uterus, okay? These are carried to the uterus by the oviduct or the fallopian tube, right? We will talk about its different parts. Now, this the next part is, you see a pear-shaped structure here. This is hollow structure, right? This is uterus. Ye uterus hai, and uterus is followed by cervix, okay? This is cervix and this is vagina. Ye vagina hai. तो ये हमारे हो गए एक्सेसरी डक्ट्स, राइट? एक्सेसरी ग्लैंड्स के अंदर आती है मैमरी ग्लैंड्स. यहां आ गई मैमरी ग्लैंड्स. नाउ यू सी दीज मैमरी ग्लैंड्स आर नॉट डायरेक्टली एसोसिएटेड हियर. ओके, एज वी हैव स्टडीड द रिप्रोडक्टिव ग्लैंड्स इन मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम दैट दे आर लोकेटेड इनसाइड द सिस्टम ओनली. But here they are not present in the system, but they are controlled by the hormones which are produced by the ovaries. The ovaries produce estrogen and progesterone hormone. The two hormones are produced by the ovary. One is estrogen and another is progesterone. The progesterone hormone is required throughout the pregnancy. This is responsible for maintaining the pregnancy. Okay, and the estrogen is required for the female secondary sexual characteristics like the development of hair under the armpits and around the genital area. Okay, the enlargement of breast, this is all because of the hormone estrogen. And also the menstrual cycle is controlled by these hormones, right? So these hormones are also produced by the ovary along with the gametogenesis, that means the egg cell, right? So this is the ovary. So this is the ovary. Now द ओवरी हैज गॉट वेरी थिन एपिथीलियम. ओके, तो एक तो यहाँ पर बाहर एपिथीलियम होती है एंड इट हैज गॉट टू पार्ट्स हियर. ओके, एक तो पेरिफेरल पार्ट है और दूसरा अंदर वाला पार्ट है. द पेरिफेरल पार्ट इज कॉल्ड द कॉर्टेक्स, दिस इज कॉल्ड ओवेरियन कॉर्टेक्स. ओके, एंड द इनर पार्ट विल बी कॉल्ड एज मेड्यूला. सो दिस विल बी कॉल्ड एज मेड्यूला, राइट. सो द ओवरी इज कवर्ड बाय अ वेरी थिन एपिथीलियम एंड देयर इज अ पेरिफेरल कॉर्टेक्स एंड इन द सेंटर द सेंट्रल मेड्यूला इज प्रेजेंट. एवरी टाइम वी गिव द टर्म मेड्यूला, द स्ट्रक्चर विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द सेंटर, जो स्ट्रक्चर सेंटर में प्रेजेंट होता है उसको अपन मेड्यूला नाम देते हैं, राइट. तो पेरिफेरल पार्ट हो गया कॉर्टेक्स और सेंटर वाला हो गया मेड्यूला. नाउ लेट्स टेक द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फेलोपियन ट्यूब. अपन फेलोपियन ट्यूब की बात करें, सो इट इज समवॉट लाइक दिस. दिस इज द ओवरी एंड दिस इज द फेलोपियन ट्यूब, राइट. सो हियर आई हैव जॉइंड. नाउ यू सी इट हैज गॉट the funnel like structure in this way. Okay, so it has got three main parts. The initial part, which is closer to the ovary, which is quite broad. Okay, so this funnel shaped structure is called as infundibulum. This is called infundibulum. Now, infundibulum has got many finger-like projections. See, these are the finger-like projections present here. And these finger-like projections, they are called as fimbri. They are fimbri and they come closer at the time of ovulation. Okay, like this is the ovary, this is infundibulum and these are fimbri. So, their position is like this. And at the time of ovulation, the infundibulum and the fimbri, they come closer to the ovary to receive the ovum. Okay, ovum ko receive karne ke liye ovary ke bilkul nazdeek aa jate hain in this way, right. So this funnel shaped part is infundibulum. Now this portion, the middle portion, is called ampulla. Right, this is called ampulla, and when we go further, we will find a very narrow passage. Okay, so that narrow passage is called as isthmus. So this is called isthmus, right? So in this way, this is the structure of infundibulum.